As the parade of graduates approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today. Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Georgia, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Maryland, South Carolina, New Hampshire, Virginia, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, Louisiana, Indiana, Mississippi, Illinois, Alabama, Maine, Missouri, Arkansas, Michigan, Florida, Texas, Iowa, Wisconsin, California, Minnesota, Oregon, Kansas, West Virginia, Nevada, Nebraska, Colorado, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Arizona, Alaska, Hawaii, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands. State flags, order, arms. And now, we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Drill Hall and are announced in the following order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we welcome today's graduating division. Thank you. Division 303. Division 308. Today's graduating performing unit is Division 939. Division 939 provides the arrival honor staff, honor guard, the recruit review commander, adjutant, and graduates who provide supporting assignments for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions, right, face, section leaders, fall out and collect outer garments.
Set, fire, carry, arms. Fire, platoon, formation, march.
Divisions, counter, march. Divisions, halt.
Prepare for review. Outer normal interval. Dress left. Dress. Ready. Front. Left. Face, at a close interval, dress right, dress. Ready, front, right, face, parade, rest.
May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command.
Division commanders, left or right, face parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant John Godfrey, Recruit Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I'd like to welcome you to today's passing review. Today, you will see 11 divisions comprised of 832 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon to join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit positioned at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Apprentice Alexander Kinney from Draken, Massachusetts. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the Triple Threat Unit on their 8th week of training, the State Flags Unit on their 9th week of training, and the Staff Unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed in their divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags that they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from their right. Division 301, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Eric Serrano. Petty Officer First Class Egrin Garcia Quintana. Petty Officer First Class Matthew Suddy. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Apprentice Brendan Mandabon from Mesquite, Texas. Division 303, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Alex Diaz. Petty Officer First Class Luke Funk. Petty Officer First Class Matthew Coleman. Petty Officer Second Class Jocelyn Downey. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Anastasia Charles from San Antonio, Texas. Division 305, commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Jacob Cahuto. Petty Officer First Class Zhong Guang Liu. Petty Officer Second Class Timothy Adams. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Adrian Amadis from Brooklyn, New York. Division 306, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Courtney Gandhi. Petty Officer First Class Rasan Graham. Petty Officer Second Class Tony Brown. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Zanu Fullerton from Davie, Florida. Division 307, commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer John Parkin. Petty Officer First Class Raquel Lara. Petty Officer First Class Kyle McDonough. And there, Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Jamie Giuliano from Janesville, Minnesota. Division 3, 08. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Connor Moyer. Petty Officer First Class Laura Nino. Petty Officer Second Class Laurette Price. And there, Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Alexander Brady from Garing, Nebraska. Division 3, 09. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Travis Blaze. Petty Officer Second Class Alyssa Aguada. Petty Officer Second Class Ethan Fleming. And there, Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Devin Jackson from Bowling Green, Kentucky. Division 3, 10. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Harley Suttles. Petty Officer First Class Zachary Klein. Petty Officer Second Class James Van Hook. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Airman Apprentice Cade Goffrey from Chattanooga, Tennessee. Division 3, 1-1. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Corey Roberts. Petty Officer First Class Kenneth Hatfield. Petty Officer First Class Byron Sears. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Alan Stern from Miami, Florida. Division 3, 1-2. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Michael Lagerway. Petty Officer Second Class Mauricio Monroy. Petty Officer Second Class Anthony Mullen. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Nathan Santon Silva from Lake Elsinore, California. Division 9, 3-9. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Chase Bork. Petty Officer First Class Colton Hahn. Petty Officer Second Class Jack Cotter. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Alexander Kinney from Dracut, Massachusetts. On behalf of the commanding officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you will see the ceremonial side boys, Boatswain and Honor Guard, take their places for arrival honors. This time, honor tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching on of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party?
Time early! Strike the doorbell!
Recruit Training Command, arriving. Surface Combat Systems Training Command, Great Lakes, arriving.
Order! Arms!
The guests may be seated. Will the guests please rise? Present arms.
Arms. Order arms. Chaplain Cho will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. God of grace, almighty and sovereign, on this day of celebration, I thank you for your faithfulness and your provision, and ask for your abiding presence with us today and always. As these newest sailors reflect on their accomplishment, help them to always remember the challenges they've met, the adversity they've overcome, and the growth they've experienced. God, may that reflection serve to make firm their resolve and their commitment, not simply to oneself and one's goals, but now to nation, to ship, and to shipmate. God, as we now send out these newest sailors of our fleet to meet the challenges that lie ahead, we do so with trust and confidence, knowing that they have been well-trained, knowing that they take with them the love and support of these newest Navy families. So God, I ask, grant them both humble hearts and unwavering dedication as they go forth. Bestow upon them your favor and grace, strength and courage, and your holy hand of protection. Grant them fair winds and following seas. In your most holy name I pray, amen.
At this point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's events show how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Divisions, report! Very well. Very well. Very well.
Division 306, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 307, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 308, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 309, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 310, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well.
Division 311, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well. Very well.
Division 939, all prisoner accounted for, sir.
Very well. All divisions, prisoner accounted for, sir. Very well. The Sailors' Creed.
I proudly serve my country's Navy combat team with honor, courage, and merit. represent the graduating veterans. Request permission to commence a review.
Very well. Commence a review.
Aye, aye, sir.
Hold on.
Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Commander Rick Jarko, Executive Officer of Recruit Training Command. On behalf of the commanding officer, Captain Kirchert Brooks, I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony, and I look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with you. I cannot thank all of our visitors enough for your continued support, and I am sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training. With us today is our reviewing officer, Captain Roy Hinkle, Commanding Officer, Surface Combat Systems Training Command, Great Lakes. I would also like to welcome all of the veterans in our audience today and thank them for their service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand and let's give them a round of applause. Division 939 graduates today. They are the staff unit providing arrival honors, honor guard, recruit review commander, adjutant, and support for the ceremony. Please join me in giving them and the 10 other graduating divisions here today a round of applause for their outstanding performances. This right here today is where our heritage meets the future, and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of Recruit Training Command is dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors such as those standing here this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 10 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They and others like them serve as the bedrock of our naval forces. They will join other sailors around the world to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to help keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 832 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Recruit Training Command's competitive system among individual recruits and divisions promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors, individually and as teams, met performance standards in one or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for the Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle E Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 312 has earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job exceptionally well done.
Homeland! Rust!
Captain Hinkle will now present this week's individual awards, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our Executive Officer, Commander Jarko. It is our pleasure to recognize the review commander for today's ceremony, Seaman Apprentice Alexander Kinney, Division 939 from Draken, Massachusetts. Throughout his training, Seaman Apprentice Kinney has exhibited great pride in naval service and has consistently demonstrated his potential as an effective leader. He has maintained a high standard of personal appearance, displayed excellent military bearing and command voice. Congratulations on your outstanding achievement. Well done, sailor. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Constructionman Lou Bridget Assis, Division 303 from El Paso, Texas, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of American Revolution. Constructionman Assis receives a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty. Seaman Apprentice Madeline Guidel, Division 308 from Westminster, Maryland, is the award, the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Apprentice Guidel is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Alexander Brady, Division 308 from Gearing, Nebraska, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit of the intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Brady is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor! Seaman Jamie Giuliano, Division 307 from Janesville, Minnesota, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Seaman Giuliano is presented with a commemorative plaque from our Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor! Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Emily Cristaldi, Division 307, from Raleigh, North Carolina. For demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism, Seaman Cristaldi is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Seaman Casey Reynolds, Division 303, from Reno, Nevada, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places her at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. She is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Reynolds, the staff of Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor! It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Hip, hip.
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Captain Roy Hinkle, Commanding Officer, Surface Combat Systems Training Command, Great Lakes. A native of Waterloo, Iowa, he enlisted in the Navy in 1985 and served as an operations specialist. In 2000, he was commissioned under the Limited Duty Officer Program. Among Captain Hinkle's operational tours, he served in various positions aboard the USS Bunker Hill, USS Green Bay, USS Nimitz, USS Exodus, and USS Theodore Roosevelt. His shore commands include Naval Station Ingleside, Texas, Joint Maritime Facility, Recruit Training Command Great Lakes, Surface Combat Systems Training Command, Commander US 6th Fleet, and Naval Information Forces, Suffolk, Virginia. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to Captain Hinkle.
Good morning, and welcome to all our distinguished guests, and most importantly, the families and friends of these sailors and ranks today. It is a great privilege to join you today to welcome these young men and women as the newest sailors into the world's finest Navy. I thank each and every one of you for the integral role you played in their success. You helped shape your recruit into a person who wanted to stand up for his country, who understands the Navy core values of honor, courage, and commitment, and had the drive to make it happen. We also would like to welcome all of you into the Navy family. To all the young sailors standing now before me, congratulations on your accomplishments. You look magnificent. In June of 1985, 37 years ago, I first put on the Navy uniform. Like you, I made the choice to enter the profession of arms and of service to our great nation. Each of you has selfishly answered the call to duty to serve a cause greater than yourselves. You have passed every test, triumphed over every challenge, and proven yourselves worthy of wearing the uniform that symbolizes freedom throughout the world, the uniform of the United States Navy. Whether you stay for 5 or you stay for 30 years, you have joined an exclusive fraternity of those who have chosen the path of service. Sailors, I can tell you from experience that you are about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. But I also can tell you that if you serve with honor, keep the faith with your fellow shipmates, and strive for excellence in everything you do, it will also be one of the most rewarding. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when it is most needed, when America must show a strong presence throughout the world, on the seas and in the skies. You've taken on the task of defending our nation, and the instructors and staff here at RTC have done a masterful job preparing you for that tremendous duty and responsibility. You have earned not only mine, but the respect of a grateful nation. In closing, not as a Navy captain, but as a fellow American, I'd like to be the first to say to all of you, thank you for your service. Congratulations, sailors.
Receive the salute of the graduating divisions, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our executive officer, Commander Jarko. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty.
Thank you.
join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes? Flags. Post. Section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. And without further ado, now hear this. Liberty call, liberty call. Fall.